Okay, so proceed tayo sa second part ng ating tutorial. Okay. Let's proceed. Question number 16. Determine the angle of super elevation for a 200 meter highway curve so that there will be no solid thrust at a speed of 90 kilometers per hour. Okay, so again, super elevation tayo ng highway curve, banking of highway curve. Okay, so yung formula na gagamitin natin dito is yung sinabi ko nga kanina na arctan vigor. Okay. So, the value of theta, the value of theta or the banking of highway curve is arctan V vigor. So, VV, V squared over GR. Okay. So, given dito na 200 meters yung highway, so ang radius natin is 200. Okay, since nakameter siya, yung gravity na gagamitin natin is 9.81 meters per second squared. Okay. Then 200 meters yung ating highway. Okay, ang problema na lang natin is the initial velocity. The velocity is given as in kph. 'Di ba dapat nakameters per second 90 kph. Okay. Madaming beses kasi kapag vehicle, 'di ba sanay naman talaga tayo kilometers per hour ang ginagamit. Okay, so madaming problem sa dynamics na kilometers per hour. So, isa sa mga pinakagamit na gamit na conversion is yung conversion from kilometers per hour into meters per second. Paano ka ba magkoconvert ng kilometers per hour from meter per to meter per second? Okay, kaya gamit na gamit ang convert 19 sa calculator. So, yung convert 19, that is kilometers per hour to meters per second. Okay, so ganito. So, on ulit natin. So, arctan V vigor. So, arctan V squared over GR. Ang V natin is naka 90 kilometers per hour. Pero, ko-convert mo into meters per second. So, that is shift, convert, okay, 19. Okay, so that is, ayun na, kilometers per hour to meters per second. Squared over G, so 9.81 times R, 200. So that is already the angle ng ating highway curve, 17.67. So the answer is letter B. Hindi ko na naman na-enlarge. Nakakalimutan ko lagi. Okay, again, yung kilometers per hour, convert mo sa meters per second through convert 19. Okay, so arctan V vigor. Next. An automobile accelerates at a constant rate of 15 miles per hour to 45 miles per hour in 15 seconds while traveling in a straight line. What is the average acceleration? Okay. Sagutan natin to. Okay. So, given, nag-accelerate siya. So, given ka ngayon ng initial velocity, given ang initial velocity na 15 miles per hour or mph, final velocity na 45 miles per hour, time is 15 seconds. So, yung nahanap is acceleration. So, simple lang, di ba? VI, VF, T, and G or A. Okay, anong formula ang meron nito? Okay, V of VF, T, and G. So, that is karera ng dalawang vehicle, isang Ferrari, isang owner. Sponsor is Globe Telecoms. Okay, so, hinahanap natin is A. Okay, so therefore, acceleration is simply VF minus VO over T. Okay, but the problem is naka miles per hour, ang unit natin naka feet per second. Okay? So, pag sinubstitute natin, that is 45 minus 15, that is 30 miles per hour. Okay? Over 15 seconds. Kailangan na mo muna ma-convert yung 30 miles per hour into feet per seconds. So, paano? Okay? Again, yung famous na convert 19 natin, mako-convert mo yung miles per hour magiging Ah, hindi pala. Kilometers per hour pala yung convert 19, di ba? So, ang gagawin mo muna, co-convert muna natin yung miles per hour into kilometers per hour. Okay? Bakit may co-convert sa kilometers per hour? Kasi walang direkta from miles to feet dun sa calculator, di ba? So, wala namang miles to per hour to kilometers per hour dun sa calculator. Wala nga, pero may miles to kilometer. Same lang naman ang denominator yan. So, ibig sabihin, ang pang-convert natin dyan ay convert 0.7. Okay? So, from miles per hour, yung miles lang magiging kilometers, so kilometers per hour. Once na nakikilometers per hour ka na, ito yung famous na convert 19 natin, kasi mako-convert natin from kph into meters per second. Okay? So, once naka-meters per second ka na, yung meters ang i-convert mo ngayon sa feet. Okay? Kasi yung denominator, second lang din naman. So, convert mo lang meters to feet. So, sa calculator, so that is convert 0.4. Okay? So, actually, pwede mo yung idire-direkta sa calculator. So, that is 30 shift convert 0.7. Ayan, nakita natin yung miles per hour magiging kilometers per hour. Tapos, shift convert 19 uli natin. Okay? So, yung kilometers per hour niya magiging meters per second naman. Tapos, shift convert 0.4 para yung meters per second magiging feet per second. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, ang buong denominator mo is simply 44. Okay? So, 44 divided by time na 15, kasi yun yung magiging tanong natin, the answer is 44 over 15. Oo nga naman. Okay, so, that is 2.93. yung parenthesis pala sa calculator na to, that is the repeating part. So, kung nasa parenthesis ay 3, that means that is 2.93333333. Okay, so, the answer is letter D. Okay, next. Number 18. A mango falls from a branch 5 meters above the ground. With what speed in meters per second does it strike the ground? Okay, so a mango falls from a branch 5 meters above the ground. And dinrawing pa yun, no? So that is 5 meters above the ground. With what speed does it strike the ground? So simple lang, hinahanap lang is final velocity. Okay, given ang distance mo is 5 meters, pero since pababa siya, that is negative 5. Your acceleration due to gravity, since naka meters per second, gagamitin na yung negative 9.8. Actually, negative 10 pala, sabi sa problem. Okay, gamitin natin is negative 10. Okay, ano pang given? False lang, di ba? Fall, nahulog. Okay, galing sa taas, meaning the initial velocity is 0. So, ang may formula na may VFDGO is VF squared minus VO squared is equal to 2GD. Okay, is equal to 2GD. Okay, 0 naman yung VO, so ito na lang. So, your final velocity is equal to square root of 2GD. Okay, rekta na natin sa calculator. So, that is square root ng 2 times gravity is negative 10 times distance is negative 5. Nag-cancel lang yung dalawang negative. So, the answer is simply 10 meters per second. Very easy. Okay. Proceed tayo. Okay, number 19. The acceleration vector of the Earth in its orbit around the Sun points, okay, yung vector daw ng acceleration ng Earth na umiikot sa Sun, okay, palayo ba, pa inward, same direction, or right angle sa orbit ng Sun, okay. The acceleration vector is pointing, okay, centripetal itong tinutukoy dito, so that is V squared over R, okay. So, that is pointing inward towards the Sun. Okay? Next, number 20. An astronaut carries a meter stick in his spaceship. The meter stick is aligned in the direction of the motion of his spaceship, which is moving at speed of 0.8 c. Okay, c is speed of light, ah. So, yung 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. Relative to the Earth. What is the length of the meter stick as measured by an observer back on Earth? So, ibig sabihin, kung may hawak siyang meter stick, since gumagalaw siya, nagmumukhang, okay, isipin nyo, ah, merong may meter stick na takbo, tumatakbo. Pag tiningnan mo ba, 1 meter yung stick, mas maigse o mas mahaba? Nagmumukha siyang mas maigse. Okay? So, ang tawag natin dito is time dilation. Time dilation. Wait lang. Sulat natin yung word. Time dilation. May formula ang time dilation na time dilation. Medyo ina-associate nila to sa time travel. Okay, yung time dilation. So, the time dilation, formula niya, T over TO, square root ng 1 minus V squared over C squared. Okay? Pero pagdating sa length, that is LO, original length multiplied by 1 minus V squared over C squared. Kapag time and mass, yung taas. Pero kapag length, yung baba. Kung mapapansin nyo, meron tong 1 minus V squared over C squared. Okay. So, may tawag dito. Okay. If I'm not mistaken, this is the Lorentz factor. Okay. So, actually, nung nag-board ako, basta mayroong time dilation na nangyari. Lorentz factor agad ako. Square root ng 1 minus V squared over C squared. Tapos, hahanapin ko na lang kung saan siya magmamatch. I-multiply ba? I-divide? Okay. In this case, paano natin gamitin to? Okay. So, given ang velocity daw ay 0.8 c. So, substitute natin yan na. Original length, square root ng, pataas na naman sulat ko. Nakatagalid kasi ako. So, 1 minus, ang v natin is 0.8 c squared over c squared over c squared. Magka-cancel lang naman yung c dyan, yung c squared. Okay. So, that is simply square root ng 1 minus 0.8 squared. Oops. Square root ng 1 minus 0.8 squared. Dahil nag-cancel yung c squared, so matitira na lang is 3 fifths or 0.6. So, 0.6 na original length. Since 1 meter yung original length, 0.6 times nun, so that is 0.6 meters. Alam ko may iba pang problem dito na may involved na Lorentz factor. Okay, mamaya, tingnan niyo kung ma-identify niyo yun. Basta, ang Lorentz factor, 1 minus V squared over C squared. Okay, next. Next problem. Look, hindi ko na naman na-enlarge. Ayan. Nakakalimutan ko lagi palakihan. Okay. It states that the total moment created by a force component is equal to the moment created by the force itself. Okay. Kung familiar kayo dito, kung isang force mo is, let's say, diagonal. Okay. So, pwede mong gawin, hatiin mo siya sa dalawang component, vertical and horizontal component. Okay. Pag iwalayin mo yung vertical and horizontal niya, pag kinukuha yung momentum, parehas lang din naman ang magiging sagot. Anong tawag sa theorem na yon? Ang tawag natin doon ay Varignon's theorem. Next, a 1,500 kilogram car accelerates from rest to 75 kilometers per hour in 45 seconds. How much power is supplied by the engine to accelerate the car? Okay, power, di ba? So, ano nga pa yung power? Power is simply work over time or energy over time. Kahit alin dun sa dalawa. Okay, so ang gagawin nyo lang, hanapin nyo lang yung work or energy involved. So, ano na yung given? So, mass natin is 1,500 kilogram. So, accelerates from rest. So, initial velocity is 0. Ang naging final velocity niya is 75 kph. So, ang time niya is 45 seconds. So how much power? So kailangan nyo is either work or energy. Pag may work or energy na kayo, divide sa time. Okay? Since gumalaw siya, so that must be change in kinetic energy. Okay? Kasi gumalaw, so kinetic energy final minus initial. Ano ba yung kinetic energy? Diba 1 half mv squared. Okay? So final minus initial, pero yung initial velocity mo is 0. So kahit wala na yung initial. So substitute na lang natin to. So that is 1 half times mass na 1,500 times 75. Again, kph. Okay, convert 19 natin to. Okay, para maging meters per second squared. Meters per second, then squared. So that is your kinetic energy. Okay, para makuha mo yung power, di-divide nyo lang yung energy sa time. May given naman na time na 45 seconds. Okay. So, unahin natin ulit. Solve natin yung kinetic energy. So, that is 1 half mv squared. Okay. So, mass natin is 1.5. Ang velocity is 75. Pero naka-kph, di ba? So, dapat meters per second. So, convert 19 tayo. Ayan. Meters per second squared. So, 1 half mv squared. So, yun yung numerator, yan na yung kinetic energy. So, to get power, divide it by time. So, ang time is given as 45 seconds. Press equal sign. So, that is your answer. 7,233 watts. Okay? So, 7,233 watts sa mga choices, that is letter D. 7.2 kilowatts. Next, number 23. What effect do the following forces have on a point? So 100 Newton 30 degrees east of north, 200 Newton 80 degrees south of east, 150 Newton 45 degrees south of west, 175 Newton 25 degrees west of north, 15 basta yung mga yan, okay? So ano ulit, ang hinahanap is resultant lang, 'di ba? So combined effect. So recall natin yung calculator technique diyan, that is mode complex. Then, add natin isa-isa. Unahin natin yung unahin natin yung since negative. Okay. So pag dinrawing natin siya, so pag dinrawing natin dito 175 degrees eh. Okay. So, ibig sabihin, ito, that this is the complement, ay supplement. Okay, so meron ka ditong 4 degrees. 4.5 degrees. Okay? So, that is, meron tayong 4.5 degrees. Ang direction niya is south of west. So, your answer is 95.6 at an angle of negative 175 degrees. Or in other words, that is 4.5 degrees south of west. Okay? Next. A projectile fired at an angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal has an initial velocity of 10 meters per second. After what time will it reach its maximum range? Tinira siya na at an angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal. Initial velocity is 10 meters per second. At what time will it reach its maximum range? Okay. Aha, nasa na yung page? Ayan. Okay. So, tinira mo ng ganyan. 45 degrees, 10 meters per second. Okay. So, ang importante sa atin is time yung hinahanap. Again, tulad ng ginawa natin kanina, pwede nating hatiin sa dalawa. Pataas and pababa. Usually, mas madali yung pababa. Okay. Mas madali yung pababa kasi initial velocity natin is 0. Okay? So, initial velocity mo dyan is 0. Ang final velocity mo sa baba, yung initial velocity mo kanina dito. Okay? So, ito is 10 meters per second. Okay? Since naka-angle siya ng 45 degrees, that is 10 sine 45. So, this is your initial velocity sa pababa. This is your final velocity sa baba. Okay? Given na again, na gravity is negative 9.81. Okay? Ang inaanap natin is time. We are concerned with the time. Okay? So, formula natin for time is... ano? Ayan, balik natin doon. Formula natin sa time is Vf minus Vo over G. Yung karera ng dalawang vehicle, sponsor is Globe Telecoms. Okay, over G. Okay, so that is... So, negative na rin to kasi pababa na siya, di ba? So, that is negative 10 sine 45, mawawala yung 0, over G, negative 9.81. Okay? So, this is the time it takes for the projectile to go down. Okay? So, that is negative 10 sine 45 all over negative 9.81. Okay? This is the time going down. But, ang hinahanap sa atin is the total time to reach its maximum range. Since symmetric nga siya, di ba? Ito times 2 natin. Okay? Kasi pataas and pababa yan. So, your answer is 1.44 seconds. So, that is letter B. Ayan. Next, balik tayo sa PowerPoint. The time of flight of a projectile is maximum when the angle of projection is kailan pinakamatagal bago mo magsak. Okay? Kung palayuan, pinakamalayo mararating ng 45 degrees. Pero kung patagalan bago bumagsak, okay, iba to mo ng diretso pataas. So that is 90 degrees. Next. A ball is dropped from a height above a tile floor, height h above a tile floor, and rebounds to a height of 0.85 h. Find the coefficient of restitution between the ball and the floor. Okay, ang hinahanap sa atin is coefficient of restitution. Ano yung formula ng coefficient of restitution? Okay, ito para sa mga nagbabounce or sa mga nagko-collide. So, ginagamit natin yung coefficient of restitution, yung concept niyan. Meron tayong dalawang formula for the coefficient of restitution. Okay, yung una natin is the final velocity over the initial velocity. Okay? Pero kung in terms of height naman, that is square root ng final height over initial height. Or rebounding height. Actually, hindi final kasi tatalbog ng tatalbog. Rebounding height over the initial height. Okay? Balikan natin yung problem. Sabi sa problem, nag-rebound doon siya 0.85 h. H yung original height. Okay? So, pag sinubstitute natin, numerator mo is 0.85h. Kasi h yung original height. So, initial height niya is h. So, mangyayari, cancel lang yung h. Ang sagot lang is square root ng 0.85. That is the coefficient of restitution. So, answer is 0.92. Letter C. Ganun lang kadali. Basta alam nyo lang na yung concept ng coefficient of restitution. Next, number 27. Number 27, compute the acceleration due to gravity at a place where a simple pendulum 150.3 cm long makes 100 cycles into 46.7 seconds. So, kailangan, pendulum to, di ba? So, pendulum, kailangan kabisado nyo yung pendulum formula. Okay, kabisado nyo ba yung pendulum formula? The formula for simple pendulum is T is equal to 2 pi square root ng LG. Okay, 2 pi square root ng LG, wherein L is the length, G is the acceleration. Actually, acceleration to. Okay. Okay. Pag free-falling, that is due to gravity. Okay. Yung T natin is period, ha? So, period. Ano yung period? Bago niya magawa yung isang complete cycle, gaano katagal? Okay. Dito kasi, sa problem na to, sinabi, 100 cycle sa loob ng 246.7 seconds. Ang period, bago niya magawa yung isang cycle, ilang segundo. Okay? So, yung period natin dyan, that is 246.7 divided by 100. Okay? Para makuha natin, ilang segundo bago niya magawa yung isang cycle. So, that is the period. So, is equal to 2 pi square root ng L, 150.3 centimeters. Pero dapat naka meters. Ano nga ba to? So, sa meters, that is 1.503 meters. Over, yung hinahanap natin is the acceleration due to gravity. So, yung G ang ating hinahanap. Okay, dapat 9.81, di ba? Pero, sa problem, iba. So, nangyari, compute natin. Chip solve na lang natin. 246.7 divided by 100 is equal to square root of, 2 pi pala muna. 2 pi. Ay, naku, naka-mode complex ako. Mode 1 ulit. Ulit na naman. So, divide ko na. Madali namang i-divide eh. 2.467 is equal to 2 pi square root of L over G. L is 1.503. Okay, ang hinahanap natin is ito, alpha x na lang. So, shift, solve. Solve for x. 9.75 meters per second squared. Anyway, malapit talaga sa acceleration due to gravity yung sagot. 9.8. Next. Okay. Next. Balik tayo sa PowerPoint. Which of the following does not have an effect on the momentum of a moving spherical particle? Alin daw hindi nakaka-apekto sa momentum? Diba, may impulse momentum discussion na tayo kanina. Okay, the formula for momentum is M1V1. Therefore, both nakaka-apekto yung momentum and velocity or the speed. Okay, pero yung velocity nga is dalawang factor, speed and the direction. So, ibig sabihin, ang momentum MV, ang V ay speed and direction. So, ang naka-apekto, mass, speed, and direction. Therefore, ang hindi nakaka-apekto sa kanila is the diameter of the particle. Okay? Next. Number 29. A 12-gram bullet is accelerated from rest to a speed of 700 meters per second as it travels 20 centimeters in a gun barrel. Assuming the acceleration to be constant, how large was the accelerating force? Okay. So, balik tayo sa paint. So, given mass, naka-gram, pero dahil naka-kilogram. 0.012 gram. Ano pa? From rest, so ang initial speed niya is 0. Ang naging final speed niya is 700 meters per second at ang tinravel niya sa loob ng barrel distance is 20 centimeters or yung dapat naka meters, so 0.2 meters. How large was the accelerating force? So ang hinahanap ay force. So ang gagamitin natin dito is the impulse momentum theorem. Okay, kasi lilive ng barrel eh. Okay? So gagawin natin according sa impulse momentum theorem, force times time is equal to the change in mass times velocity, di ba? So impulse equal sa momentum. Ang momentum is change in mv. So that is m final v final minus m initial v initial. Okay, anyway, zero rin naman yung initial velocity. So itong hinahanap natin is force. So kailangan natin makuha itong mga to. So ang force natin is final velocity over time. Okay, ang final mass natin is kilogram na to. 0.012 kilogram. Ang final velocity natin is 700 meters per second. And time. Oops, walang time. Okay, kaso walang time. Okay, saan natin kukunin yung time? Okay, isolve natin using rectilinear formula. Ito. Okay, kaso lahat ng formula na yon may acceleration. So, kunin muna natin yung acceleration. Okay? Sa acceleration, di ba, that is final Vf squared minus Vo squared is equal to 2AD. Okay? So, makukuha natin yung value ni A. So, that is Vf squared. Okay? So, yung Vo natin is 0 is equal to 2 times acceleration times distance na 0.2. Okay? Makukuha natin yung acceleration. Gamitin natin yung calculator. So, that is 700 squared divided by 2 times 0.2. Medyo malaki to. Acceleration ng barrel. Malaki nga. 1.225 times 10 to the 6. Kaya nga ba. 1.225 times 10 to the 6. Kaya nga ba. Now, kailangan natin is time. So, gamit tayo ng another formula na makakuha ng time. So that is Vf minus Vo is equal to AT. Okay? So ito na lang. Since ang Vo natin is 0, Vf over A na lang. So para makuha natin yung time, time is equal to 700 divided by yung answer na nakuha natin. Tingnan natin. 700 divided by the answer. So 1 over 1750. Masyadong mabilis yung bullet. So 1 over 1750 seconds. Okay, so ilalagay lang natin yung time dito. Okay? Dun sa formula natin kanina. Ayan. Sa FT is equal sa impulse momentum formula natin. Okay, so that is 0.012 times 700 divided by 1 over 1750. Okay, so this now will be the force. 14,700 Newton. Okay, at sa choices, that is letter A. 14.7 kilo Newton. Okay. And then last problem dito sa set na to. Okay, sa second episode talaga. Okay, high levels of UV radiation, either short-term or long-term, are known or believed to cause all of the following except long-term suppression of the immune system in human, fluorescence of certain material, skin cancer, or ozone depletion. Alin daw dyan ang hindi nanggagaling sa UV radiation? Okay? Yung immune system, delikado ang UV radiation sa human. Okay? So, nakasira ng immune system yan. Okay? So, mali yung A. Yung fluorescence of certain materials, familiar tayo sa UV light, di ba? So, yung ultraviolet light, nakakapagpa-ilaw siya. So, that is the fluorescence of certain materials. So, mali yung B. Skin cancer, okay, di ba? Yung UV radiation na nanggagaling sa araw, kapag exposed ka doon, there's a tendency na magkaroon ka ng skin cancer. Siya yung nagkakause ng skin cancer. So, yung C, yung A, B, and C, lahat yan ay galing sa UV radiation. Ang hindi lang effect dyan ay ozone depletion. So, the answer is letter D. Okay, so that is the second part. So, to be continued yung third part.